Profits. I've recorded this video so many freaking times because I keep messing it up and I'm trying to do it in one take. We're going to talk about how to buy Dogecoin, Dogecoin, whatever it is that you, it's a meme basically. I'm not actually suggesting investing it because maybe you'll lose your money or maybe you'll go to the moon. I don't freaking know, but we're going to do it because there's a certain way you should do it so that you actually like have control over your coins, because a lot of exchanges like freaking the sheriff of Nottingham are really stupid and they don't actually give you your freaking coins, right? They just basically, when you're buying it, you have like a credit to their coin, but you can't actually use your coin. You actually have your coin. You can't put it in your wallet. It's like really freaking stupid. So since Doge is a cryptocurrency and it's a meme, I'm making this video, and there are other cryptocurrencies that are way better, but Doge is going to the moon for the meme. So you know, whatever. If you want to learn about cryptocurrency because of a meme, I'm not going to stop you, right? So, okay, here's what you're going to do. This is the best way to actually buy Doge, because you're going to get charged the least fees and you're going to make the most money, probably. I'm not a financial advisor. But this is what I would recommend doing strongly, right? So, Coinbase is what you're going to want to use. Coinbase is cool because it is like the most trusted exchange. Anyway, Coinbase, right? You're going to buy on Coinbase, but you can't buy Doge on Coinbase because Coinbase doesn't have Doge right now. Maybe they'll add it because of the meme. Probably they won't, because they only want like legit coins that have active development and like aren't just a meme with no purpose. But yes, excuse me. So what are you going to do? Coinbase, right? Sign up. I'll put a link in the description right there. If you use the link, you get $10 free. I think you have to do like $100 deposit or something like that. But if you don't want to do that much, you can make a $100 deposit and then withdraw. Like, say you wanted to put like $50 in instead of $100, you put $100 in, and then you get the $10 promo, and then you can take $50 out, and then you've got $60 instead of $50, right? And you're not going to lose any money on that because you're just buying a coin that's worth a dollar, which is what I'm recommending. It doesn't go up and down. It can go to $1.01 or 99 cents, but you can't really lose money on a coin that's always supposed to be worth a dollar, because that's literally the point of it. So that's what I'm recommending here. So what you do? Coinbase, make an account. Link down there, $10 free. They also have like little reward promos I'm going to show you here on my phone. Dum-da-dum. I don't have much money in here in Coinbase because I transfer it all out. But okay, I got $400 or whatever right here now. So rewards, you see this? Get the Coinbase app, right? Click on the home button. You know, you got all these different tabs, but click the home tab right there. And then you scroll down and you see this big purple. Click on that, right? And you got all these rewards that you can do. And it asks you a multiple, like you watch a video that's like a minute or 30 seconds or something like that. And then it asks you like multiple choice four questions. And you pick the right answer. You can do it as many times as you want. You pick the right answer and you get like $5 or $4 or $3, depending on which coin it is. And you get all this, like, you get like $60 worth of free cryptocurrency for doing this. And you can just convert it all over. So anyway, put your money in Coinbase. $100 or whatever to get that promo for the $10. Then you get the rewards as well. You can get another like $60. And then you got $170 now of cryptocurrency. Convert it all over to DAI. And when I say put in $100, I suggest you buy DAI, D-A-I, because that can't really go up or down in value. So and also the transaction fees are like pretty freaking cheap to move it off the exchange, which is going to be the next step. So you buy it on Coinbase because they're the best. Did I go over this yet? I filmed this video so many times. I don't think I did. Okay. Coinbase, don't buy with a credit or debit card. You want to buy with your bank account. And the reason for that is when you use a credit or debit card, right, those charge a fee. Like, it's like, I forget exactly what the percentage, but it's, you know, a couple percent fee. And that fee gets passed on directly to you because you're trading one currency, US dollars, for another cryptocurrency or whatever, Doge or whatever else. So when you make that exchange, you know, the merchant, the person selling the cryptocurrency, the credit card company, to be able to process payments, they charge that merchant a fee. And so since the merchant gets charged a fee, they just pass that fee on to you with a really bad exchange rate. So if you don't buy with a credit or debit card and you use your bank account, you get a much, much better exchange rate. So go ahead and do it that way. So you do that, and it might be, maybe it's $3 fee or whatever to buy with, even with your bank account, but that's still way better than your credit or debit card. And then you get the $10 promo, you get $60 of rewards. So your $100 is now like $170 minus the $3 fee or whatever. We're going to say $170 for easy math. $170, you convert your rewards all over to DAI. So you've got $170 in DAI on Coinbase. And now what you want to do, since you can't buy Dogecoin on Coinbase, you want to move it over to Bittrex, which is the best exchange. It's the exchange that I use. It's awesome. So you take your $170 in DAI and you're going to transfer it over to Bittrex. And I'll put a link down below to Bittrex. You can sign up there. I don't know if that one has a reward or not, but they have some sort of like little affiliate link or something that I can put in. But this is actually what I have done for, you know, always buying cryptocurrency. This is literally what I do. I mean, if I have, you know, if there's affiliate links for things or promos or deals, I'm going to throw them down there. And like, I think on Coinbase, it gives you $10 and it gives me $10, whatever. You know, you can, if you want to be a jerk, you cannot use the link, but I'm not like recommending that you use my link just so you'll use my link or something when there's actually a better way. Like, this is literally what I do for my cryptocurrency stuff. So it's like, I'm just recommending it to you. And if there's a way that we can each make $10 out of it too, then that's great, right? I'm not like trying to be like, ooh, here, $10 so that I can make $10. Let me recommend something stupid, right? I don't do that. I just recommend what I'm actually using. So you get your money on Coinbase, and now you make your Bittrex account, and then you're just going to send your DAI from Coinbase over to Bittrex. And like I said, the reason we're doing DAI is because it's always worth a dollar. You could do it with Bitcoin, but you're going to get charged stupid transaction fees to send Bitcoin. Might be $5 or $15 or whatever, depending on how congested the network is. So if you use DAI, it's just going to be a dollar or something like that to do the transaction. Shouldn't be too bad. And also, DAI always stays worth a dollar. So if you put in money and then it has to sit for a day or two to, you know, while the thing's pending, that way it's not going to be like go up or down in value and like mess you up. So you got your money, Coinbase, you're sending it over to Bittrex. And how do you do that? So I'm assuming you've made account on both of these. And I guess one other thing I should say, they have like stupid freaking rules. Like, this is not the companies, Bittrex and Coinbase, they do not want this information. They do not care about this information. But the government has these stupid know your customer, blah, blah, blah requirements that make them have to like collect all this like random information about you, like all of this stuff. And so they're not like trying to scam you or anything by asking this, and they're not going to do anything with it, and they don't even want it. It's just that the government has made all these stupid rules that they like have to get all the stuff. So like, if you're signing up, they might be like, take a photo of the front and back of your driver's license. They don't want that. They just have to, because like the government is like requiring that, which is stupid. But whatever, I can rant about that at a different time. So just know it's like annoying to create your account, but it's not that bad. You just like, you know, what's your name? Where do you live? Blah, blah, blah. I think they even ask for like your SSN and stuff like that, but it's whatever. These are like really big, like millions and millions of dollars are transferred all the time. Probably billions of dollars actually are on these exchanges. So it's not like, you know, you're fine to give them your information. It's nothing weird. So sign up at Coinbase, you buy your DAI, you do the rewards, you get $170, you're gonna transfer it to Bittrex. And then on Bittrex, the way that you're gonna do that, you click on your holdings tab, and you type in DAI for DAI, and you should have you should see it like pop up. There's a little toggle switch for like show zero balances. So you wanna turn that on, because in Bittrex, you're gonna have a zero balance because you don't have any there yet, right? And type DAI and search, and it'll pop up, and you should have on the side, you'll have a withdraw deposit, but you can't withdraw anything because there's nothing there. So you're gonna deposit, excuse me. It'll want you to generate a new deposit address. So you just click the button, and then you've got a long string of gibberish, and it'll say like, deposit DAI here, make sure it's whatever, whatever, Ethereum token, yada, yada. So you copy that long gibberish looking DAI address, right? DAI, DAI address. You copy this long string of gibberish on Bittrex, and you go over to Coinbase and you click on DAI, you know, the coin that you have, hit send, and then you paste in that long string of gibberish and hit send, and it'll shoot it over to Bittrex. Might take half an hour or something like that. You'll see it immediately, but Bittrex wants to see a bunch of confirmations to make sure that like it's legit and it's not like, you know, just make sure that the transaction came through. So after a couple confirmations, you know, you'll see that come through in half an hour or whatever, and then your money is on Bittrex and it's not in Coinbase anymore. So on Bittrex, you're gonna take your DAI, and DAI is always worth a dollar, and you're going to trade it for another coin called Tether. USDT is what you search for, USDT. And you're going to trade your DAI for Tether. And Tether is also always worth a dollar, but it's just like more used, but you can't use Tether on Coinbase, which is, you know, silly, but can't use Tether on Coinbase because you know, I'm not even going to go into the reasons because you don't need to know. You're going to transfer your DAI over to Bittrex, convert your DAI to Tether, and then you can trade your Tether into literally whatever else you want. So there are a bunch of coins that are great, but of course this video is about Doge. Now, Doge, like I said, doesn't have active development, literally just a meme fork of Litecoin. Probably, I mean, you know, we'll see. We'll see what happens. People say it's going to the moon, and it's going to the moon for the meme. It's not going to the moon because it actually has any potential or there's anything good about it. It's just a meme right now. So everybody's dumping money in it, and as long as you are one of the earlier people to dump in your money into Doge and people keep doing it, then you can cash out at a high price and make a lot of money. But then if you dump in at the highest price, then you're not going to make money because then everybody previous is going to be cashing out. It's a meme, you know, it's a meme. Everybody's putting their money in it, and it's really, it's a coin that is totally worthless. But if you can put your money in it and then other people put their money in it and then you can pull out before they do, then you make money. It's kind of silly, but yeah. So this is, I know this is going to get views though, because everybody's buying Doge right now. They say it's going to the moon. It's going to a dollar. I don't know. I don't personally have very much in Doge. I have it in other coins that I actually have, you know, great hope for the long-term success of the coin. But if you're getting into it for the meme, that's totally fine and a good way to get a feeling of how cryptocurrencies work and stuff like that. Anyway, so on Bittrex, you now got your Tether traded over to Doge or whatever. So you just type D-O-G-E and you should see a little, you know, Doge. You can click on it and it'll say, do you want the Doge to Bitcoin? Do you want the Doge to USDT Tether? Or, you know, probably some other ones. So you just click Doge to USDT, or it might be flipped. It might be USDT to Doge, whatever. Click on that. And that's where you can trade your Tether for Doge directly. So it's it's annoying to get your money into cryptocurrency because, of course, the person taking all the risk is the merchant. And, you know, just like with cash, like if I physically hand you cash, you then have the cash and I can't just take it back from you. With online payments, like with credit cards and stuff like that, credit card payments can be reversed. So the merchant's taking a risk because they're giving you a cryptocurrency payment that cannot be reversed, just like handing someone cash. You know, that payment can't be reversed, and then they're just hoping that you're not going to reverse the credit card charge. And you know, they could sue you if you did. But you know, they're taking some amount of risk there, so that's why there are like more fees, and then also just using credit cards, the merchant pays fees. So they pass those fees on to you in addition to giving you a worse exchange rate and all that stuff because they're taking some risk to accept a potentially reversible payment for something that can't be reversed. So getting your money into crypto is a little bit annoying, but then once you do that, you know, it's super easy to convert crypto to any other kind of crypto or back into dollars or anything like that. It's really easy to go from crypto to dollars, but it's hard to go the other way because, you know, the merchant is always taking a little bit of risk there, unless they're literally trading you for cash, which is hard to do with the internet because you can't physically hand somebody cash. So yes. Let me see. I've talked about a lot of stuff. I've rambled a lot. Okay, let me just talk. Let me peek at my time here. What is my time on the video? My battery is at, what is that? I don't know. Pretty dang low. I've talked for 12 minutes. Okay, I can talk for another second. If you're interested in cryptocurrency, and I think you should be, even if you're not a very techie person, because so many, like there's, it's so easy to make so much money with cryptocurrency, right? It's not like eBay or Amazon dropshipping or something like that, where you can make somewhat consistent sales all the time. With, you know, with cryptocurrency, you can make a ton of money, and then maybe it's several months where you can't make any money because, you know, the market's just being dumb, but then it comes back and then you make a ton of, like, it's inconsistent, but it's a really great, easy way to trade and make some money as long as you're smart about it, right? So some rules of thumb for trading, right? If something, it's called FOMO, so fear of missing out. If, say, you know, a coin's doing like this, and then it shoots way up really high, you think, oh my gosh, this coin's shooting up. We don't know where it's going to stop. It could keep going forever. I need to dump all my money in it right now because it's going to the moon. We don't know where it's going to go. If you just don't ever do that. It's called fear of missing out. Whenever something shoots up a ton, the temptation is, oh, it's going to keep going. It's going to, who knows where, you know, I need to throw my money in here. And you, sometimes you make money doing that. But then a lot of the time, you know, you throw your money in right here and then it goes to here and then it crashes and then your money is worth less and you lose money that way. So what I recommend doing with cryptocurrency is you look at a couple things. So first is you want to make sure the project is legit because if, you know, you want to make sure that there's a purpose to the coin. It's not just some like random coin that has no point, right? Make sure there's a purpose. Make sure that there's a good development team that can actually, you know, keep working on it and improving it and all that stuff. Because sometimes people try to kind of BS it and they'll be like, here's a cool idea. We have no idea how to make this, but we know how to make some really basic cryptocurrency. And then we're just going to say that we want to add all this stuff that we don't know how to do. And then they get a bunch of money in it. And then they just, since they have a bunch of the coin, they sell the coin, drops the, you know. So that happened in 2017 some. So you don't want to, you know, buy into anything like that. And even if you hear YouTubers and things talking about it, you don't want to just buy into a coin just because you're hearing about it, right? You want to actually look at it, make sure it's legit, make sure the idea is good, make sure the development team is good, you know, see what they've done in the past. Are they making a bunch of progress? Did, you know, it was here and now it's here and now it's here and you found out about it here and they've done a whole lot. That's one thing. Or is it that it's brand new and they've got ideas that haven't really delivered anything? So if it's a really cool idea that's really solving a problem and then the development team is doing a great job keeping up with it, you've seen evidence that they can actually like do what they're trying to do and they're working hard on it, then great. So the other thing is too, don't invest on a really high price. You want to invest when it's, look at the past month or the past 3 months, and if the price is like higher than it's ever been, don't invest. Unless it's like a long term, like you're holding it for several years because you think way in the future it'll be worth more, even though it's high right now. So don't invest on a high. You want to invest when it's, you know, at the average price of the past month, 3 months, something like that, or if it's, you know, way down. Also, the other thing is refuse to lose money, right? So say you buy Bitcoin at, say you bought it in 2017 at the highest price, $20,000 for one Bitcoin. Say you bought $100 worth or $1,000 worth of Bitcoin right then. What happened then after that? Well, in, you know, late 2017, early 2018, the price went from $20,000, crashed down. It became worth $6,000, went to $3,000 for like a month and back up to $6,000. If you freaked out and said, oh no, my money's worth so much less, I better pull it out at 6,000 before it goes to 1,000 or whatever, something like that, then you lost money. So the way I think about cryptocurrency is, one, I don't invest in something that I don't think is going to do, you know, I don't think is going to really do really well long term. So I don't really care if the price goes down in a year or if it goes down and, you know, it's lower in 2 years or whatever. If I think it's going to, I guess that's kind of a stupid way. I don't care if it's down this month or next month or even all of this year, because if I think it's going to do really well long term and it's going to be higher than it was when I invested, then I'll just wait until it is higher and then I can take my money out. So if you just think of it that way, you say, I'm putting money in, but I won't take it out. And if it goes down, right, I'll just leave it there and wait. Then really the worst thing that can happen is your money's kind of locked up while you're waiting. And then you just, you know, you wait until it's back and it's profitable to pull it out. So that's what I always do. I just don't invest in things that I don't think will eventually be worth more than they are now. And then if they go down, I'll just wait. And if they go up, then I can figure out how much of a profit I want to take out. Cause that's the hard part too. It's like, you know, you've got a coin. I have a coin, right, that I bought at 2 cents, about 100,000 of these at 2 cents. And then it went up and it went up to like, it went up to 8 cents. The struggle is always, do I pull it out now at 8 cents? So I pulled out most of it at like 8 cents, and then it continued on to like 14 cents. So it's like, should I have waited? But there's no way to know where the top's going to be. So you kind of have to decide, like, how much profit do I want? What am I cool with? Because you got to sort of balance like missing out, because you don't want, you know, if it's 8 cents and it's going to 14, it's like, do I sell here? Because that's a really good profit. I paid two, four, six, eight. We got 4x'd my money. Am I good with that? Do I want to take out some profit, or do I want to take out half and then keep the other half in case it goes higher, but then maybe it'll go down? Or do I want to pull it all out and then hope it crashes and then buy back in on the crash? But then if the crashes, if it, you know, you sell it at 8 cents and it goes to here and it crashes here, then you would have been better off not. So, you know, it's a fun balance. I should probably, my battery's probably getting pretty low here, but, so I'm just going to give you some coins that I think are very legit. Of course, you big coins like Bitcoin and Ethereum and stuff like that, those of course are, you know, doing great. I'm sure they're going to 2x, 5x, something like that over the next several years. But yeah, maybe even more. But, the thing is, so those are more safe options, but they're also, they don't have as much upside as some of the smaller altcoins. Altcoins are just any cryptocurrency that's not Bitcoin, pretty much. If you can find a really small project, like, for example, the one that I'm mostly invested in is LBRY credits, LBC. Those are on Bittrex as well. They're worth like 10 cents right now, but there's only $40 million in the project, which is like Bitcoin, I don't remember what it is exactly, but I think they have like $500 billion invested in Bitcoin, and there's like $40 million in LBRY credits. It's like very small, but the development team is active all the time. It's basically, LBRY credits are online, decentralized, uncensorable YouTube that is not controlled by anyone. It's controlled by the people, and nobody's like running it. So it's not like YouTube where they can say, we're doing this now and change it. We're doing this now. They can't take videos down. They can't, they can't, it's uncensorable. They can't just change their mind. There's basically, if you're a little techie, this will make sense to you. If you're not, it won't. And that's fine. Just trust me. It's cool. If you're techie, basically it's a blockchain like Bitcoin. It's a blockchain. But in addition to the transactions, they also have like magnet links to torrents in the blockchain. So since the blockchain cannot be changed at all because it's technologically impossible, it's basically like, think of it like a collection to torrents that are videos. That's all peer-to-peer, so you don't need servers in the middle. Nobody can shut it down. Nobody can censor it. The only thing that can happen is you have clients that access the blockchain. So if the client manually wants to say, here's a blacklist of we're going to block these videos or whatever, then the client can do that. But you can just switch to a different client or make your own client if you know how to code. So it's basically decentralized, uncensorable YouTube. It's great. There's a whole lot to it. If you go to the FAQ, you can find it. And I'm uploading all of these videos that you see on YouTube. I'm uploading all of them. to LBRY as well, because I think that's what 85% of my portfolio is LBRY credits, because I really think they're going to explode. They're like 10 cents right now, and I think they're going to be up to like $1 pretty soon, in like a year or something like that, or you know, sooner, a year and a half, I don't know, we'll see. But it's growing like crazy, and with all the all the deplatforming and censorship and all that stuff, YouTube is making tons of people mad, and tons of people are leaving, and LBRY is just open. It's for everybody. It is uncensorable. It's it's not curated by like, you know, a company or anything like that. It's literally just a protocol. And all this content is going up. So it's, you know, there's less content than YouTube. There's some things that need to be fixed, like the search function isn't great yet. But you can follow people on there. You see their posts. They're in order. There isn't an algorithm that's designed to be addictive and get clicks and maximize watch time and all this stuff. It's actually just more like, think old school like Instagram, when the posts were actually in the order that they came out and it was great before they changed it to like relevancy and like what they thought would keep you on Instagram for the longest and stuff like that. So LBRY is great. 10 cents a credit right now, and they're blowing up, tons of new users. That's the one that I really recommend the most, because it's like great. And I have, you know, you can follow me on it. I'll put my thing down there. I have my Luke Profits Life channel, which is sort of just like vlogs and things like that. And then I've got my, of course, this channel, all of these videos. And you can sync your, if you have a YouTube channel, right? You can sync your entire YouTube channel. Just go to lbry.com/YouTube. You can sync all of your YouTube videos that are public over to LBRY, and then any new video you upload automatically gets synced. So, you know, if you're a YouTuber, you make videos, you can literally sync them and they'll automatically get synced, and then you get paid for all the views that you get. You get like half a LBRY credit for every single view that you get. So that means that like per 1,000 views you get on LBRY, you make like $50, and that's at current prices, and it's in LBRY credit. So if LBRY credits go to $1, then you're making $500 for every 1,000 views that you get. So it's really sweet. And the market cap, like I said, it's only $40 million. So they've got tons of YouTubers joining, and the credits can be used. The credits actually like are useful for something. They can be used to promote your videos, promote your content, and you don't lose the money. Think of it like all your videos are based, think of every single video is a savings account. If you fill up the savings account that the video has, then that video gets boosted because they can see you think it's valuable. So that gets, you know, a lot more people are gonna see it. But then at any time you can say, okay, this video doesn't matter anymore. I'm going to pull my money out of it. And then it's going to go, it'll go back down in search results because So basically you put your LBRY credits in, it makes the video boosted. More people will see it. You make money from the views, and then you can pull the credits out, keep all the new credits that you made. And then you can, you know, sort of shift it around however you want. So LBRY is awesome. It's really cool. And no ads either. It's like decentralized YouTube with no ads. So if you want to watch my videos with no ads for free, go ahead and follow me on LBRY. Links down there. You can sign up for LBRY. LBRY is great. Some other noteworthy projects. Monero is great because it is like literally digital cash. It's like what people think Bitcoin is, but Bitcoin isn't actually. It's actually anonymous online. Online digital money that you don't know who has what balance or who sent what money where. It's like everybody thinks that Bitcoin is some sort of spooky, anonymous online currency. But Bitcoin, actually, it's just a public ledger of, you know, this person sent this much money. And if you can link a person to a wallet, then you know who sent what money where and exactly how much money every person has, which isn't ideal. So Monero is cool because they actually like respect privacy and don't that stuff. And if people are like, oh, but it's anonymous, doesn't that mean it's used for crimes and bad things on the dark web? Well, I mean, like, yeah, I mean, criminals could use Monero and they do use Monero, but also a lot more criminals use cash because that is anonymous. You just hand it to somebody and then it's like, ooh, most crimes are done with cash, right? It's not like, ooh, somehow it's like it's an online version of cash. Ooh, new, oh no, bad guys are gonna blah, blah. It's literally just cash, but it's digital. It's like, you know, it's got the same amount of anonymity. If I've got physical $100 in my wallet, nobody needs to know that except for me that I have $100 in my wallet, my physical actual wallet, US dollars cash in my wallet, right? And then if it's like it's the same thing, it's just digital, then it's like, ooh, it's just as scary as a normal freaking dollar bill. Ooh, except it's digital, whatever, you know, calm down. Monero's cool. LBRY, I think, has the most gross potential, but it's also a little riskier. 10 cents right now, that's a great price to get in my opinion, because I think it's going to be a lot higher. I think it's going to a dollar and then far past, because if LBRY credits eventually, say 10 years, it's got the best chance of anything I've seen, 10 years, 15 years, replaces YouTube. If that happens, each LBRY credit's going to be worth more than $340, and right now they're 10 cents. So that's why I've got most of my portfolio in LBRY, because it is kicking butt. Follow me on LBRY. LBRY is doing great. It's really cool. The development's great. But yeah, so LBRY, Monero, Bitcoin and Ethereum, obviously, but those are, you know, less to be made because they're so popular. And then you've also got Algorand, which is pretty cool. A little bit high right now. 60 cents is a little bit high. I bought a bunch at like 34 cents. It's like 60 something cents right now. So if that comes down a little bit, Algorand, I think, is ALGO. I think that's a good option. And then REN, R-E-N, is pretty cool because that is for decentralized exchanges. And there's, you know, some good stuff coming with that. And I think if we get more regulation in cryptocurrency coming down the pipeline, then decentralized exchanges are probably where it's going to go. So I think that that has a lot of potential as well. But yeah, if you want to see more cryptocurrency content from me, then let me know. Leave me a comment. Freaking actually click on this video and watch it, because so many people don't watch my videos that are about cryptocurrency, which is annoying because it's like, I'm telling you how to make money. You want to watch my eBay dropshipping, my Amazon dropshipping, all that content, but then you don't watch my cryptocurrency content because it's nerdy, it's techie, it's scary, it's whatever. No, it's a way to make money. It's not that hard. It's easy. I will teach you. I will show you how you do this thing. But yeah, whatever. All right, cool. Love you guys. I'll see you later. This is a random one-off, and hopefully my camera has not turned itself off yet, because the last several times I've done this video, my camera's turned itself off. Are we still recording? Yes, we are. Yes. Okay, we've done it. All right. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys back with another video. And hey, watch me on LBRY. You can watch without ads, and I'll make more from each freaking view anyway. And get into cryptocurrency. It's cool. $170 of rewards or whatever. Links in the description, and I'll also put my LBRY channel. Yoos!